Okay, so most of you guys are fairly educated in this. How many people here think the idea of genetically modified organisms as food is a good idea? Everybody's good. How many people would just soon not have genetically modified organisms on their food? Okay, so it's actually kind of 50-50. How many of you believe that if somebody's going to package a food with genetically modified organisms in it and put it in the grocery store, that it should be labeled as such? And how many of you just don't care? A vast majority. Well, that tells me how this next thing's gonna go. I am not going to say that I am categorically against genetically modified organisms, although the idea of eating a tomato with salmon genes in it freaks me out just a little bit. Because I know that's not gonna happen in nature. I mean, how would a salmon even meet a tomato? Much less date, court, fall in love, and have whatever they would have. But I do think that it's something that we need to think about a lot, because there have been a lot of times in human history that science has gotten away from us when we thought we were being ever so clever. So I want to share some thoughts with you, and I'm going to do so in a song. There's my mighty staff, and there we go. Let's get this drapery off of me. Whoa. Oh, that's just a screen. It's obviously a very, very cheap food god costume. Where did you get that harp? I like that.
You're losing your divinity.
I lost my divinity? Is that what that sounds like, when you lose your divinity? I didn't think that sounded like harps. That sounded like something altogether different. So, I decided to write a song about GMOs, because whenever I can't make up my mind about something, that's kind of what I do. And I was thinking about science and history. I was thinking about a favorite doctor of mine. No, not Doctor Who. Dr. Frankenstein. Or Frankenstein, depending on which version you like better. But, you know, things didn't go really well for him. Everybody knows the story. Everybody's seen at least the original movie, you know. Dr. Frankenstein, you know, makes a new guy out of old guy pieces, and then things get out of hand. The monster throws a little girl on a lake, she drowns, and ends up in a windmill burning down. Everybody knows the story, right? Well, I was thinking about, you know, GMOs are kind of like that. And so, here's a little cautionary tale that I just want you guys to think about as you go forward in your lives with GMOs. Okay? Can you do that? All right, here we go. You ready?
We'll have chickens grown to frightening dimensions.
Listen up, modern man, 'cause we best understand. Just because we can, don't mean we should. Sure, science is tasty, but we get too hasty. Well, we're not taking orders from a stellar name Rick. Yes, times, they are changing, but chromosome rearranging might not be worth engaging in. Well, at least not yet.